Software is eating the world, claimed Marc Andreesen back in 2011, and more firms are being transformed by their applications. As a result, organisations are increasingly being challenged to deliver software solutions faster and more efficiently than ever before. Could taking a DevOps approach provide the answer? MeetTheBoss TV caught up with HP's John Jeremiah to find out.
Modern businesses are driven and defined by their software. And so now, rather than being able to deliver goods and services faster because you're able to manufacture them faster, you really have to integrate software into that solution. And often software is the solution that is being delivered. That now means that to go faster, to deliver at speed and innovate at the speed of the market, the speed of software delivery has to match that. And that doesn't mean delivering bad software faster, but it means delivering high quality, reliable, and trusted software at the speed of the business. And that's what's driving a lot of the adoption of DevOps and what people are trying to solve. There's always been a running conflict between dev and ops. You know, the dev team, they're always incented to go fast, they're incented to deliver on time, and they have these constraints, and they do everything they can to meet them because they're being held accountable for on time, on budget. On the other hand, the operations leaders, the operations team, they're incented to keep, to manage the costs, to maintain high availability, to keep incidents down. So what we end up with is two teams with opposing goals that come into conflict with each other. It's a vicious cycle that we've gotten into where development is being pushed to make things bigger and bigger and more complex, which makes it harder to deliver quality. When in fact, the opposite is true. If the whole team owns quality and owns velocity, and we focus on smaller changes, if we apply the principles of lean manufacturing and reducing the size of changes, we can actually accelerate the speed of delivery and we can also increase quality. We don't have to sacrifice quality to go faster. In fact, the opposite is true. If we go faster with smaller size changes and if we're committed to the same goals, we'll actually increase quality while going faster. The first thing that we'll get from this is that IT will now be able to be much more responsive to business demand. So when a business leader recognizes an opportunity in the market, recognizes a threat in the market, and needs IT to respond, because the delivery mechanism will be tuned to go faster, smaller changes going faster, they'll be able to react to that. This is an existential threat for many companies that things like Uber will show up that will disrupt their market, will disrupt their business. Companies who really get it, who get ahead of this and start to own innovation, they can be the disruptor. They can come into a market and they can go into different markets with offers that aren't expected. I think retailers can become banks. I think we will see companies start to move into other areas where they're able to serve their customers and meet the needs of their customers in ways that are totally unexpected. And I think we're going to see more and more of that as people start to get ahead of the curve and start to understand how faster software delivery can become a business advantage. It starts with leaders of creating a culture where the teams can take ownership, the teams can innovate, and the teams can try to solve this. And part of the leadership role there is alignment of the goals, of trying to get away from having the head of apps and the head of ops having conflicting goals. We really have to try to get alignment at that level. I think the second thing that needs to happen, or I would suggest is the key, is to start to identify pilot teams or small groups that can start to experiment and start to pave the ground. There is no one answer. DevOps is something that it's about a series of practices and cultures that come together to go faster. So you need to have some teams working within your culture, piloting that. The third part of it really is to establish, I think, the principles of an end-to-end view and focusing on flow without sacrificing quality. If those are the focus and the objectives these teams are trying to establish, there will be outcomes such as agile will become a way of working. It'll lead you to that. It will lead you to automating, doing things in continuous integration, adopting those practices. But I think those three steps are the way I would start that transformation and start driving it.